This is a case of a boy, 24 years old, with presentation of abdominal distension. Serum creatinine is 11. Normal, this is less than 1.3. There is a gallbladder calculus. Liver is normal. Now, first thing to note in the scan is a gross ascites. Ascites is generalized, no septation seen. There is fine debris shown later in this video, which shows infection. Now, this is right kidney. This is small, echogenic. Size is 6.2 cm. The normal size is plus 9 cm in adult. Cortex is 2 mm. Normal, this is plus 10 mm in adults. So, this is small kidney with thin echogenic cortex and grade 3 loss of CM distinction. Now, this is not a simple chronic renal disease, nor multiple echogenic areas of stones symmetrically placed in whole kidney. Left kidney also shows the same findings. Sizes are mentioned in the video. So this is a case of chronic severe medullary nephrocalcinosis with end stage kidneys causing renal failure and gross ascites. There are two types of nephrocalcinosis, medullary and cortical. Medullary nephrocalcinosis is 95% of all cases, and cortical nephrocalcinosis is 5% of all cases. There is abnormal deposition of calcium salts in the medulla of the kidney. In the early stages, renal medullary pyramids become more echogenic than the adjacent cortex. These can be seen on ultrasound scan. But when further time passes and disease becomes chronic or severe, there are medullary calcium formation and stone formation occurs with aquastic shadowing in the kidney. If the disease and causes are not treated, it can cause chronic renal injury. Patient may not have any symptoms, or symptoms are related to the causes which are causing nephrocalcinosis. If the renal stones are present, symptoms may include blood in the urine, fever, chills, nausea, vomiting, and severe pain in the lumbar region. There are many causes of medullary nephrocalcinosis. Some causes are hyperparathyroidism, medullary sponge kidney, renal tubular acidosis, excess vitamin D, sarcoidosis, hyperthyroidism or hypothyroidism, Cushing syndrome, bone mets. Now, important thing is this, that patient may not have any alarming symptoms for most of these causes in the early stages, especially if a patient is living in the villages. As happened in this case, the patient boy lives in a village and have low education and low awareness level. Patient only knows about the disease when there is abdominal distension and there was first scan of the patient, which first time told him that there are end stage kidneys of the patient.